Obeying the Gospel, August 29th. Seeking the Kingdom of God first. But seek first the Kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Matthew 6:33. A firm decision must be made to seek first the Kingdom of God. Very few people are willing to do this, even among those who profess allegiance to Christ. As Charles Venable said, quote, "Everyone wants the Kingdom of God, but few want it first. Everyone wants high achievement, but few want to pay the price. Everyone wants God, but few want to put Him first." End of quote. Especially in the modern culture of so-called Christian nations, very few do anything more than add a little Christianity to their busy lifestyles. But Jesus was clear. We cannot serve two masters. Matthew 6:24. He said, "Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters." That's Luke 11:23. When it comes to our discipleship to Jesus Christ, a radical choice has to be made. He will have all of our hearts or none of them at all. But did you notice the last part of Jesus' statement in Matthew 6:33? "If we put the kingdom first, all these things will be added to you," He said. Whatever other needs we have, these will be supplied, but we have to be willing to do without them, if need be, in order to maintain the priority of the kingdom. And, of course, the very worst thing we could do is to put the kingdom first, quote-unquote, because secretly we think this will be the best way to get all these things. Whether to put God's kingdom first in our hearts is a hard decision. Hard because of the sacrifice required and also the carefulness demanded by the decision. Consequently, we often dither about it and procrastinate. I love the American Heritage Dictionary's definition of dither: to be nervously irresolute in acting or doing. We need to hear Joshua's challenge. "If it is evil in your eyes to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve." Joshua 24:15. Or Elijah's exhortation: "How long will you go limping between two different opinions? If the Lord is God, follow Him. But if Baal, then follow him." 1 Kings 18:21. Or Moses' plea: "I have set before you life and death, blessing and curse. Therefore, choose life, that you and your offspring may live." Deuteronomy 13:19. In this life, it pays to be careful what we grasp and what we give up. William Law was correct when he said, "If you have not chosen the kingdom of God first, it will in the end make no difference what you have chosen instead."